Okay, so welcome back everybody. So in this section I'll show you just a trick. It's quite simple actually, how we can use what we know about linear regression already to not only fit straight lines but also to fit polynomials like parabolas or third order polynomials to a given data set. So let's see how that is done. What we want to do is we want to fit a model y as beta 0 plus beta 1x, that was the old approach, and now plus beta 2x squared and so on up to beta p x to the p. And that looks a bit scary at first because x squared, for example, is not a linear function and xp even less so. So it first seems that linear regression is the wrong tool for that and we would maybe need nonlinear regression or something. But it turns out that is not the case. Namely, linear regression, the thing which needs to be linear is how the response depends on the coefficients beta, and the dependency on beta is still perfectly linear. There are no powers of beta and no nonlinear functions of beta, so that fits perfectly into the framework of linear regression if we just use our inputs cleverly. And what we need to do is we choose first input is x, second input is x squared, third input is x to the 3, and so on up to p's input is x to the p. And now if we have data, then we can write the design matrix, and well, the first column will still be ones. And then what we do is we apply this rule to the first data point. So here where we originally wrote x11, now our input data is just numbers, not vectors, for this to make sense. So given x1 up to xn in R and responses y1 up to yn in R, what we need to write here is then x1 squared up to x1 to the p, and then the second row is x2, x2 squared, and so on up to x2 to the p. And that goes all the way down to the last row, xn, xn squared, xn to the p. And with this design matrix, we can just use what we know about linear regression and just do the usual linear regression. So that's not even a generalization or something like it. It is just a trick which tells us if we construct the inputs like that, then the fitted model will be a polynomial like this. That's nearly all there is to it. So I think what I'll do is I will just show you how that works in R. So what I want to do is I want to try a new data set. I don't think we have used that so far, which is called M cycle. Let's see that. M cycle, and that is included in this MATH library, which I've just loaded. So that has data from a simulated motorcycle accident, and there are two columns, and it looks like that. And you see that looks like data where you could use smoothing to get a smooth mean line, but clearly a linear model would not be appropriate. And if we try to fit a linear model anyway, you can guess how that will end. So what we get is a straight line, which has not much to do with the data. So what I want to do here is I want to cut off maybe the outermost values. So let's say index is, let's try times 15 to 40 maybe, is which m cycle times greater or equal to 15 and m cycle times less than or equal to 40. Let's try that, and let's do plot M cycle, and now I use only the rows which I've just selected. Then that looks a bit more like we could fit a polynomial to that. So let's say that's our data. I just write D for data. And what I want to do is, well, let's first try a straight line, but what I want to do is I want to fit a third order polynomial to that. So straight line would be the same, but I just write data equals d. That, well, works a bit better than before, but not really good. But what I really want to do is I want to do times plus times squared plus times to the 3. And now I can do lines fitted m. maybe I do that in red, that it shows more clearly as different, and maybe I do a bit wider line, and that did not work. Okay, I found it. So the mistake was I needed to set the x values correctly. So that is a third order polynomial, and you see third order polynomials look like that, so that is kind of good. But I want to show you two problems with this model. So the first one is third order polynomials grow quite quickly. So if we go back to the original data, we do plot M cycle, and now I just plot my fit into this full data set. And you can understand that will not fit on the left and on the right, because I didn't use this data, but you will see it does not fit quite badly actually. So what do I need to do? I do lines, then M cycle times, and then I do fitted M, and I do new data is, I think I can just put in M cycle here, and it will pick out the times values. And I need to use predict, and then new data here. So that is the curve, and it looks innocent enough, but if you think which values it will reach by the time of the leftmost data point, that will be quite large. So let's just fix ylim to -1000 +1000. Let's try that. That was nearly large enough, but not quite. So you see outside the interval that polynomial is totally out of line. You can now nearly not see the data, and we still don't see all of my fitted polynomial. So that is really only good in the middle region where I used it, and that grows quite quickly at the outside. And for this reason, polynomials are really not so good as global models, but they can be used as local models. Good, so that's the first thing I wanted to show you. Let's go back to our nicer picture here. And the other thing I want to show you, these models can have quite bad conditioning. So if we look at the condition number, we need, or we can just type kappa m, and you see that is a huge number. So our rule of thumb from the level 3 part of the module was, if this condition number is less than 10, we are okay. And if that is bigger than 30, then we have severe collinearity in the matrix X. And you see that is larger than 30 by a huge margin, so that will be pretty bad. So if we look at the matrix, so if we do X is model matrix M, and then we do pairs X, you see what's going on. So because they are all functions of the same data, that correlation between times and time squared will be extremely high, and time squared and time third, it's not totally straight lines, but that is definitely severe collinearity, though that is not a good thing. And there is a cure for that, namely what you should do is you should not use times as it is. As you see, times really goes from 15 to 40, so we can take a point in the middle, like say 28, and we can fit the model in terms of times minus 28. So let's try that. Times minus 28, and times minus 28 squared, and times minus 28 to the 3, and 28 is just a point I randomly picked as being in the middle of the interval. So if I do that, the plot command, so if I fit this model like that, then the curve looks the same. But if you look at the condition number, you see that is now 1600, where before it was, let's count digit, it was 2 millions before, and now it's 1000. So there is still severe collinearity, but from 2 million to 1600, that is a dramatic improvement. And if we do the pair scatter plot, you see what's happening, because we centered the data now at a point in the middle. These curves look more interesting, and for example, down here, it kind of changes directions. So these curves are much easier for the linear regression algorithm to work with. And later, instead of 28, which I chose quite arbitrarily, we will use the center of the window, which we were looking at for our local regression estimate. So that's the second thing I wanted to show you. If you do the polynomials here naively, you may run into troubles with collinearity. We didn't see any ill effects here, but still, we know from the previous lecture there may be problems. And if for the polynomial you use x minus a point in the middle, then you can greatly improve the condition number. Good, and that's all I wanted to show you here. So the key point is we can use just the LM function to fit polynomials rather than straight lines to the data. So that was polynomial regression. And now the only thing we still need to do is we need to combine polynomial regression with the regression with weights I discussed earlier, and then we will get a new method for regression smoothing. And I'll explain that in the next video, so see you very soon.